The first Alice was a rightful woman of the spade. Unrighteously she held a sharpened blade within her hand, never hesitating to slay all within her way, creating passive blood that followed her through Wonderland. Deep inside a darkened forest, Alice walked the line, captured and imprisoned as embodiment of sin. Everyone out for the murderous wake left behind, no one would have suspected that she had ever been. The second Alice was a fragile man of the diamond, the broken echo of his lies within demented words. He sang his twisted melodies to all in Wonderland, creating the image of the sick and the disturbed. Deadly and so beautiful, a voice just like a rose, shined by a man who silenced him to death. A single rose bloomed in his place with no music composed. A twisted grin, this dying man lay breathing his last breath. The third Alice was an innocent young girl of clout, an enchanting, graceful figure in the world of Wonderland. She charmed the people in the land to every beck and call, a peculiar country answering to each command. So she rose into the throne to be the country's queen, consumed by paranoia of her own impending death. Soon the queen succumbed to a dark and nightmarish dream, disguising kindness, loathing fate, she secured her regime. And as this passed, two children walked in the woods, partaking in tea underneath the trees they never part. They found an invitation to the queen. It was the Ace of Hearts. The fourth Alice was a duo of curiosity. Both were lost and could not find the boat where they began. And so they ran through countless open doors so recklessly. A brother and a sister running wild through Wonderland. A stubborn elder sister, a witty younger brother. But they had strayed too far into Alice's Wonderland. They were never woken from their terrifying dream. Forever they would wander this twisted fairy tale.